By default, Peace saves the current changes you make on the equalizer and effects interfaces to a file called last configuration. This is done at each shutdown of Peace, so you get the same configuration settings back when you start up Peace. But you also can save your configuration under a name which makes sense to you. Besides, some nice save options can be set specific to a configuration. This short tutorial explains these options. Before I go into these options, I'll explain what a configuration actually is, as there might be some confusion here. A configuration is the total of all settings on the main equalizer interface, including the selected audio device, plus all settings on the effects panel, and all entered commands on the commands window. So a configuration may not only be an equalizer configuration. In fact, it could only be a combination of effects, or even only some commands you have entered. By the way, configuration is the term Peace uses. Equally, using a name like preset or profile is alright too. After clicking the save button on the main interface, you can enter any name you like, including a description if you need one. Especially if you want to share your configuration to others, it might be beneficial to add a longer description. Sharing can also be done by sending me the configuration file. I'll publish it on the Peace website. Talking about websites, you can enter a specific one to you or to your configuration. A user can easily go to this entered website by right-clicking on the configuration in the configuration list on the main interface. As you probably already know, a hotkey can be attached to a configuration in order to activate it whilst being in another program, like a game or a media player. By clicking on the hotkey button on the main interface, you can select a hotkey for the current configuration. For convenience, this hotkey can also be set on the Save Configuration window. And a specific icon can be selected to distinguish between your configurations. This icon is then displayed instead of the default blue Peace icon, so you can easily see which configuration is currently active. The last option is to explain the configuration identifier. For normal purposes, giving a number to a configuration isn't very useful, but it is possible to use Peace as a driver for your own Equalizer Effects app or widget. For this purpose, an identifier may be needed to alter some settings on the Peace interface, but explaining all this goes beyond this tutorial.